we talked about how Hinduism needs to become more modern, etc., etc. And the people or youngsters of today are not going to relate to principle-based Hinduism. Personality-based Hinduism, I suspect. So my question to you is this. Will religion, all kinds of religion, which are personality-based, become obsolete in the near future?
Very fast. This is a great worrying thing, including Hinduism. Any Hinduism that is strongly personality-oriented is going to lose its flavor very quickly. The world is, it's not because of me. The world is moving so fast. There's so much engagement with the youth in the social media, and they can pick up information, knowledge from all over the place, so that the pace of evolution is gathered, you know, they become much faster, much more frenzied, very fast. So because of that, this idea of kind of focusing on a monotheist God and supreme person, even though Ramanuja promoted the idea of Vishnu, whatever, this is not going to attract the modern thinking youngsters, whether it's Hindu or non-Hindu. This is my real experience. They are not interested in this kind of personality-oriented religion whatsoever. They are moving away very fast from it. Unless you kind of force people into believing it by brainwashing them, they will not agree with it. If you brainwash them, they'll believe anything. So some religions are brainwashing the youngster to believe, and they play along. Fair enough, we wish them well. But it's not going to work, because the cat is out of the bag, if I can use the word. The youngsters are allowed to think for themselves, make their own decisions. Because you allowed them this, given them this permission, this monotheism is going to struggle big time, big time. So where is the resolution? Suppose Mr. Lacan, you say, Mr. Lacan, you talk about Brahman and Atman, they like it, they won't like it either. You say, there's good stuff. No. The only way they'll come to the idea of principle-oriented Hinduism is not by studying the ancient scripture of Brahman and Atman. It is the science of today. It is modern science that holds the key. Ancient prophets perhaps excited a few hundred, you know, disciples. Modern science, I'm telling you, my friend, don't underestimate the power of potency of science. This potency of science, through the integrity of science, we are now discovering dramatic material, dramatic materials. If you want to really engage with religion now, says, Mr., should we study the Gita? I say, no, study modern physics, modern consciousness. Study these ideas. You'll soon get, you know, kind of thrilled. So some of the things that we are discovering, the cutting edge of sciences, are now pointing to a spiritual dimension that is easy to absorb, easy to digest, easy to engage with. And I'm telling you, within no time, this particular vision is going to be embraced by thousands, hundreds of thousands of thinking youngsters throughout the world, from every religion and no religion. And once they get grabbed that, they will get charged up. And their spiritual progress will happen very fast, very quickly, with the compliments of modern science. This is my true belief. I believe in it very strongly.